Welcome back to a new video in LINQ Tutorials. Today I will explain a new operator under partitioning operators. It's SkipLast operator. I already talked about two other operators under partitioning operators. These are Skip and SkipWhile operators. If you want to learn more about them, please check these two videos. I explained each operator in details with different examples. In this video I will explain SkipLast operator. Let's go. As the name suggests, this operator is to skip the last elements of a sequence. Let's see the definition of this operator. It returns a new enumerable collection that contains the elements from source with the last count elements of the source collection emitted. It means, I have a sequence of elements, and I want to skip only the last specified elements from it. We have only one overload for this operator. We can use it with a number in brackets, like this one here. So this operator means now, that I want to skip the last three elements of a sequence. Let's see the following query to understand how does this operator work. I have here a query to loop an array. This array contains 5 numbers. And I have a condition to get only the numbers, which are greater than number 5. At the end I am selecting the matched numbers and converting them to array. The result of this query is an array, which contains only these 3 numbers, because only these numbers are greater than 5. Assume I don't want to get all these numbers as output. So I want to get each element from the sequence, except these 2 numbers. To do that I can use different operators, like take, skip or many other operators. But if we are using these operators, we have to do some steps, so that we skip the last 2 elements. But we can also use skip last operator, which is easier than the other operators. I will use this operator in this way after the query, because I want to filter the output of the query. I only write the operator with number 2, to skip only the last 2 elements. As you know, the result of the query is the following collection, which contains these 3 numbers. Now using SkipLast operator means, that I want to get all numbers, except the last 2. The query returns now only this number as array. This is how the operator works, if we are using it after the query. Please make sure, you add a conversion operator after SkipLast operator, to convert the output to a specific data type, like here in this example, I used toArray, to convert the output to array. We have to do that, because SkipLast operator returns always enumerable collection, therefore we have to convert this enumerable to a specific data type. But maybe you need the output as enumerable. In this case you don't need to add any function. So you can use only the SkipLast operator after the query without anything after it. I use the operator here after the query, to filter the output of the query. But we can also use this operator within the query in any position. For example the following query. I use SkipLast operator directly at the beginning of the query. Let's see how it works now. So I have an array consisting of 5 elements. SkipLast1 will return all elements from this array except the last one. It means, the array contains now only 4 elements, which we want to loop in the query. The condition here is to get the numbers, which are greater than 5. So the result of the query now is the following array, which contains these 2 numbers. This is how to use the operator in from statement. We can also use the operator in where condition or as mentioned anywhere in the query, or also after the query. Let's now see the following query, where I use SkipLast operator with number 6. As you see, I have only 5 numbers in the array. What do you think? What will happen here? This operator returns now an empty collection, because the sequence contains only 5 numbers, and we want to skip the last 6 numbers. It means, we don't get an exception because the number is greater than the count of elements. But the operator skips all elements. So if we have the count of elements in the sequence, we skip the count elements, else we skip so many elements, as what we have in the sequence. And now because the collection is empty, we don't have an output from this query. The output will be an empty array of type integer. One last thing about this operator. We can use this operator only as method, as I did in these examples. It means, I cannot use it in query syntax. Only in method syntax, or mixed syntax. That's all about this operator. Now I will switch to UiPath to show you some examples, where we can use this operator. In this example I will show you, how to use this operator for a data table. I have the following sequence. First I have a build data table activity, where I define a table. The table is stored in this variable, which is of type data table. Let's see the table. It consists of 3 columns. I have the student ID, the name and the marks for each student. I want to write a LINQ query, to get the best 3 students from this table. It means, I want to get only 3 students as output, which have the best marks. Let's see how to do that. Here I have an assign activity, where I have the link query. The result will be stored in the same data table variable, but I can also use a new data table variable for the output. Let's see the query. It's a very simple query. I have first a loop for the rows of the table. After that I am sorting the rows using the column marks. The sort is in descending order. This means, the best students are at the beginning. After that I am selecting all rows. After the query I use take operator with number 3, to get only the first 3 students from the table. After that I used copy to data table, to convert the output to data table. So I didn't use SkipLast operator now. And here I have a loop for the data table. In this loop I want to print out the content of the table. Let's execute the query to check the result. As you see, I have only 3 students as output. It means I got only the best 3 students from the table. This was using take operator. Let's now try to get the same result, but now using SkipLast operator. I will use SkipLast instead of take operator. Using this expression, I am getting the rows count of the table. As you know, we have 6 rows in the table. And I added minus 3 to skip the last 3 rows. It means, the number here is now 3, which is 6 minus 3. It means, I should get only 3 rows as output. These are the first 3 rows, because I skipped the last 3 rows. As you see, I didn't use a number directly, but an expression which returns a number. It means, we can set directly a number, or we can calculate the number using variables. Let's execute the query to check the new result. As you see, I got the same result. I have only 3 rows. These students have the best marks. It's the same result, what I got before using take operator. So we can get the same output using different operators. Let's now move on to the last part in this example. Now I don't want to use the operator after the query, but within the query. I will use it for example at this point. I want to skip the last 3 rows from the table. I have an error here, because I am trying to use skip operator for a data table. This is not correct, because this operator is only for enumerable type. So I need to convert the table to enumerable. For that I will add the function as enumerable. Now I don't have any errors. So what happens now in the query? I skip the rows at the beginning, which means that the table now contains only 3 rows. After that I am looping the rows and doing the next steps. So we have only these 3 rows now. Using order operator will sort the rows in this way. And I am selecting the rows. So I should get these rows as output. Let's execute the code to check the new result. As you see, I got these rows as output as expected. This is how to use the operator in a link query. So we can use the operator either within the query, and also after the query. We have always to set a number. We can set a number directly, or we can set an expression, which returns a number. That's all about this operator for today. Before ending this video, let me summarize this operator, and also the other 2 operators, skip and skip while. I will show you, what does each operator mean and what is the difference between these 3 operators. Let's start with skip operator. Skip bypasses a specified number of elements in a sequence, and then returns the remaining elements. I have the following sequence for example. If I am using skip operator with the number 3, I will get the last 2 elements from the sequence, because the operator skips the first 3 elements. We use this operator in this way. Only the operator with the number of elements, which we want to skip from the start of sequence. Skip while. It bypasses elements in a sequence as long as a specified condition is true, and then returns the remaining elements. For example, the following sequence. I use skip while operator with the following condition, to skip the numbers which are greater than 3. The result here will be the following sequence, which contains only the numbers, which are smaller than 3. As you see, I still have some numbers in the sequence, which are also greater than 3, but I also got them. This happens because the condition was false at this point. In this case, the operator skips only the elements, which meet the condition until this point. Nothing else will be skipped after that. We use this operator in this way. Only the operator with a condition in the brackets. And the last operator is SkipLast. It returns a new enumerable collection that contains the elements from source with the last count elements of the source collection emitted. For example, the following sequence. I use SkipLast with the number 3 to skip the last 3 elements from the sequence. The result will be the following. We use this operator in this way. Only the operator with the number of elements which we want to skip from the end of the sequence. This is how can we use each operator to skip specific elements from a sequence. All these operators can be used only as method, which means that we can use them either in method syntax or mixed syntax. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you still have any questions about this operator or any other operator, please don't hesitate to write us back. Thanks for watching and have a great day.